Hello, friends, and welcome to a very new topic on public speaking. This short video will help you tremendously to improve your way of delivering not just a speech, but a fantastic and an effective speech. So let us begin. A great speech should include first introducing yourself, then opening your topic, then coming to the main points of your topic, closing your topic with a message, and then the thank you. So remember these 5 points. That's IOBCC: introduction, opening, body, conclusion, and closing. Let's move ahead. The introduction part. First, tell minimum 3 things about yourself. Keep it short. Your name, work, college, job title. One very important and amazing aspect that no one knows. Like you run a marathon, or you're a karate champion, or something like you have done, which not everyone does. This will make you stand out and make the audience look up to you. Okay, that will help you to attract the audience towards yourself. The next will help you to connect with them. Next one. Now how you come to the opening. Before you open your topic, avoid saying my topic is benefits of water. Instead, you can ask your questions to your audience by connecting with them, by asking questions. Do you know what is most important in life? Do you know what is abundantly around us? Do you know what is H2O? Can anyone guess? If no one can guess, then I will tell you my topic is the benefits of water. You can use some of these points which are on your screen. I have an idea. Would you like me to share with you all? So I had a rough day. What about you all? I fell from the bed. Pardon my English. Can anyone guess my topic? So why am I standing here before you today? Why are you in this audience today? This will help you to connect and grab their attention. Next, now coming to the main point, your main topic. So it depends on the time limit given to you on your speech. It could be 15 minutes. It could be 2 hours, or it might be the whole day. But be brief and to the point. Avoid using large words. We know that you're good in English, but you need to get down to your audience to connect with them. Use simple language. Do not use harder, heavier language, which is used within or at your back-end team, with your back-end team. Ask questions in between so that the audience don't get bored and keep up with and see that they keep up with you. Use bullet points if you're using a PowerPoint presentation. And do practice your speech at least minimum 5 times or 3 times. Avoid going unprepared or if you're not ready. Now coming to the conclusion. The conclusion is why you are giving the speech. What is in it for me? What is in it for the audience that I have shared my such a long and precious speech? I want to open your eyes. I want to change the world. I want you to help me change this world. I'm giving you a message so that I share my knowledge. I help you to improve. The people of this world can benefit. Improve your confidence and self-worth. Right? Exactly. And coming to the closing. When you're closing a speech, don't just say thank you, but thank the audience from the bottom of your heart. But thanking by saying some of these words, thank you for listening to me. Thank you for your precious time. Thank you for providing me this platform. Thank you for this wonderful opportunity. You have been a wonderful audience. Have a great evening. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you for bearing with me. You can use some of these excellent words and sentences. It will help you in becoming from a standard speech giver to an excellent delivery of speeches. So let us move ahead and practice a few topics. You can see it on the screen over here now. So my dear friends, please go ahead, keep doing your mirror practice and improve your speech. And I would like to thank you very much for your time, and I would request you to please watch this video, forward it to your friends, and subscribe to my channel.